Good afternoon, everybody. So now I'm going to tell you about the introduction to embedded system. So embedded is a magic word in the technical world, in the technical world, because embedded is there everywhere. So if you take the definition of the embedded system is, so embedded is it's a part of the system. So embedded system can be a standalone system or it can be a part of a bigger system. Okay. So it contains a hardware, normally a programmable hardware, and some of the actuators, it may be mechanical or electrical. So put together, the embedded system is part of a system in order to import intelligence into any system. If you want to make a system intelligent, then definitely you have to put a controller, a programmable device, and some of the sensors and actuators. So the system now becomes more intelligent. That is most modern. So these are all the places where the embedded system is being used. There is no thing is left out without the embedded system being in use. So if you take an aerospace, is a place where the latest technology, the embedded system is being utilized. Like virtual displays and controlled by wire, that is fly-by-wire technology. So it was invented for the aerospace industry. Now the same technology is being utilized in the mechanical industry. So if you take the latest car or other any other motor automobile, so the fly-by-wire technology is being utilized. That means if you pressing a pedal, for example a brake pedal, so previously the brake pedal mechanically it will be connected to the braking device. So whatever you are doing in the pedal, the same thing will be mechanically transported or transferred to the end system, that is a brake shoe or something. But in this case, the pressing is faced by a device and it is being given to the controller. The controller in turn takes the effective measure. So the fly-by-wire technology is being introduced nowadays for all the industries. If you see the automotive field, if you take a car, there are a lot of sensors. A lot of sensors are available, which makes the car more sophisticated, user-friendly. It is very safe also. Okay? So everything is being sensed. If you take any mechanical system, the mechanical system is not a pure mechanical system nowadays. So without a piece of electronics, no mechanical system is available. Even if you take a drill machine, the motor and speed control is there as an electronic device. So this is a complete automotive thing where the exact mechatronics is being used. Mechanical with electronics is combined together. The mechatronics is being used effectively in the case of the automobile industry. So if you take this one is the ECU, engine control unit, which is present inside the bonnet of any automobile. So, it's a reliability. If you see the reliability of electronics and embedded system, so it is a challenge actually. If you open the bonnet after driving a car for a while, for half an hour or 1 hour, you cannot even touch the bonnet of the car. But inside the bonnet, very near to the engine, this entire CPU is there. The controller with all the electronic devices there present inside the bonnet, looking after the entire control of the engine. So that is the very reliable system is being introduced. So if you take the communication, here also, if you take the health station or satellite or handle devices or any other encrypted technology, encrypted voice technology that is being utilized in communication, everywhere the microcontroller plays the major role. That's all. So more than 99% of the work is being done by the microcontroller or microprocessor, rather than the TX, RX or ARM devices. So if you take the medical, again, it helps the doctor in a very effective manner. Okay? In order to diagnose a patient, it's very very important, it is often necessary definitely to use a medical equipment, medical diagnostic equipment. Without these medical equipments, I don't think a doctor will treat the patient in an effective way. It is not possible nowadays. So if we go for electrical, again the electrical grid has become smart grids. So the AC, that is power quality analysis, is being done by using the standalone or controller systems, which constantly monitor the power quality and take the measure in order to correct the power quality. So if we take the DC output, that is the photovoltaic cells, which produces a DC output, if you want to connect the power to the grid, then it has to be converted into an AC, so it has to be synchronized with the grid. So for that we will be going for a power electronics, where the controller plays again a major role in order to sense the phase angle and power and voltage and other things. So in order to take the power and give it to the common grid. So there are a lot of DC-DC converters are being utilized nowadays. If the grid is DC, again if the device has to use a lesser or higher DC voltage, then you will be going for DC-DC converter, which takes the DC as the input and DC as the output with a different voltage and current proposition. So if you go for defense, a lot of things are happening in defense. Actually, nowadays the war becomes a smarter war actually. So remote sensing is possible by using a satellite or by using fire and target weapons. It is possible to target any, that is pinpointly target any device, any place, any enemy place. So by using this technology, it becomes so smarter. So this is a device which is used to shut down the cockpits, that is quad cockpits and other things. Okay, so this is an antenna. It's a highly directive antenna, so you can move the antenna. So it actually shows in which direction the arc wave from the copter is coming. So by directing this antenna, it is possible to precisely target the copter. It is possible. So this is the fire and target weapons. You can fire, you need not accurately target, accurately focus the target. So just focus approximately, you fire it, then the weapon definitely goes there. It hits the target accurate. It's a fire and forget weapons. So if you take the household, everywhere the electronics is present, and too the microcontroller is present. You take a micro oven, you take a digital LCD screen, or induction stove, or any other things in that matter. Whatever the equipment you are using in the kitchen and the other places in the household, definitely the RGB controller is. Okay. So on the whole, the millions of controllers are working in and around the world in order to make our life so simple. So without a smartphone is not possible. Smartphone, inside the smartphone there are a lot of controllers. Then after that, the communication is being carried out. The communication is being controlled by the controllers present as well, a cell phone tower, or it may be a control section or whatever, even inside lights and everything. So the controllers, what are the, that is controller, this is the microcontroller. So it's a programmable device. It's a programmable. Why we are going for programmable devices? The same device can be used for different applications. So if it is a fixed hardware, then you have to design and produce a hardware for that particular application. So if it is a programmable hardware, the same hardware can be programmed to do different functionality. In that sense, the controller used in a microwave oven can be used in a washing machine. The same controller can be used in case, even in a laptop or whatever. A laptop, even if you take the laptop, the keyboard sensing is being done by a microcontroller which is present as a part of the piece. Mouse, if you take, there is a controller inside which produces a signal according to a movement. So the controller, you cannot name a device without any controller nowadays. So it is like, so these are all some of the major manufacturers of the microcontroller, microprocessor. That is a programmable device. The Texas Instruments, Microchip, Silicon Lab, Renesas, Intel Corporation, Deloitte, then Fujitsu, ST Micro, Zilla, and Priest. So these are all some of the important manufacturers. There are several. So now we are going to see how to program a microcontroller. What are the steps in programming microcontroller. As I told you, the same controller can be used for different applications. It depends how you are programming the device, how effectively you are programming the device. Okay? So like, we know the language, we know the grammar, but how many of you can write a poem? It is not possible for everybody. So even though we know all the rules and regulations, it is not possible to write a poem. It is their own thing, you know. So like that, the programming is also like that. So you have to take a lot of effort, a lot of practice. You should love the way you are programming so that it can be precisely programmed in an effective way. Okay? So some of the steps that are involving in programming is, first you have to write the program in a human readable language. That's why we call it as a high level language. So it can be C, C++, Java, Python, JavaScript, lot of other languages are also there, where the writing the software will be very easy. That means you can remember things, you can remember the instructions. After writing the program, before seeing the program, you will be able to understand what is the program is going to do, what is the particular line is going to do. So in order to understand, in order to keep the program for reuse, in order to understand for the others too. So suppose I am writing a program, some other person is coming and saying, so after seeing the program, they can come to a conclusion what is that particular program is doing. So that the program is being written in a human understandable language, that is a high level language. Then the machine will not understand, that means the controller will not understand the higher language. If a program is written in C or C++, directly the C or C++ code cannot be put inside a microcontroller. For that, it has to be converted into a machine understandable language. Machine understandable language. That may be zeros and ones. That may be zeros and ones. Actually, in between the human readable, that is a high level language, and then there is an assembly language, after that it comes the machine language. So high level language, as I told you, is it is human readable. Okay. So the next thing is an assembly language. The high level language is irrespective of a controller, you can write the C code. But if you go for assembly language, for every controller, for every series, for every manufacturer, there are a set of assembly language, assembly code. If you want to program a particular device, we should know what are the assembly instruction that is being present for the particular IC. Otherwise it is not possible. Even after that, if you want to write a program for a bigger device or a bigger function, then it is impossible in the case of an assembly language. Because a lot of hundreds of lines, thousands of lines you have to write, you have to remember what you have written previously, it is impossible. So that is why we are going for the high level language. So now the high level language will be converted into the corresponding assembly language. Then assembly language will be converted into zeros and ones as the machine readable language. That is the second step. You are writing the code, you are compiling it in order to produce the zeros and ones. Then zeros and ones has to be put inside the microcontroller or inside the hardware. That is the programming part. Okay. Here we will be using another hardware. So in between your PC and the microcontroller, there will be another hardware which takes the zeros and ones from the PC and it places the zeros and ones inside the controller. That is called the programming device. So in order to burn the code inside the controller, we will be using another hardware that is called a program. So these are all some of the compilers. As I told you, we will be writing the program in C or C++, then it will be converted into hex or zeros and ones. For that, several compilers are available. So every compiler will be supporting some device. As I told you, a lot of manufacturers are there. Everybody will be manufacturing microcontroller with different capabilities. So when you are choosing a compiler, that is a controller, for that particular controller, what are the compilers that is being supportive, you have to choose that particular compiler. Then you have to take that compiler, you write the code in that particular compiler, you compile it, then it produces the hexadecimal code and it will be stored in zeros and ones when it is connected to a hardware that is called a program. So next we'll be seeing how a controller, a big controller, in my case I am taking a big controller and I am using a micro C as the compiler. So I am going to write a small program in the micro C and compile it. I will show you how the X, Y will be like that. Then I am going to store the zeros and ones inside the microcontroller. Then I will show you how the control is working.